Before disaster, Champlain Towers was in the middle of addressing issues identified in a structural safety review. It's an unusually strict requirement in South Florida for high-rises 40 years old. Kit Miyamoto runs a global building engineering firm.
They recognize that so-called maintenance issue exists in the Miami area, I believe, and also that obviously right next to the ocean.
Our review of building codes in seven big cities shows the norm is to require checking structural integrity only when a tower is new. After that, cities do different things. We found a lot of places with skyscrapers call for regular checkups of exteriors where things might fall off and hurt someone below. Definitions of a high rise and how often reinspection should occur vary. Every 5 years in Boston, up to every 12 years in Chicago. Seattle recertifies towers only after damage from something like an earthquake. Houston says you have to inspect apartment buildings every 4 years, but not condominiums unless someone makes a complaint. The International Code Council develops model building codes. Currently, those guidelines don't say anything about whether a high-rise should be re-inspected, only that they should be maintained and stay structurally sound. That may soon change.
We're going to have to be more diligent, I think, in the future.
Dominic Sims is CEO of the Code Council. The group will go over findings from investigators at the rubble and will meet in August to discuss next steps.
We're going to want to hear from the experts, local code officials like you've talked to, engineers.
Sims says there is a very strong likelihood the council will adopt new guidelines for routine reinspections, at least for areas in the bullseye of climate change, where sea level rise and stronger storms have been a growing concern.
The forces that are acting on buildings are changing.
But Miyamoto says regularly recertifying high rises everywhere would be an overreaction.
This is a really, really rare event.
But without routine reinspections, it's up to condo owners in a lot of cases to detect trouble themselves and agree to pay for costly fixes. While we don't know what brought down part of Champlain Towers, we do know owners have been grappling with repairs an engineer warned would be extremely expensive.
There was leaks in the garage. There was cracks on the balconies. So, yes, you need the money to fix it.
After the tragedy in Surfside, Sim says people will expect tougher building codes.
Just the mere fact that it did fall, and in the U.S., that's not something that I think the public will accept.
Patrick Terpstra, Newsy.